Hi Sagittarius, welcome to Miracle the Tribe. My name is Ayushi. This is going to be your November 2018 reading for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon and Rising. Let's see what is coming up for Sagittarius for November 2018, Sun, Moon and Rising. Celtic cross for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon and Rising. 10 card Celtic cross for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon and Rising, November 2018 reading. Okay. So bottom of the deck is Daughter of Wands, which is Sagittarius, Leo, Aries card. Let's see what's heart of the matter. Father of Cups, what's crossing you is Ace of Swords. What's grounding you is Three of Wands. What's in your past is Mother of Swords. What's on your mind is Four of Cups. What's in future is Seven of Wands. How you come in your reading is Five of Pentacles. Your surrounding, the Chariot. Your hopes and fears, Six of Cups. Your outcome, Daughter of Cups. What I see here is that some of you are dealing with a water sign, which is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, or you are dealing with a air sign like Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising. Some of you could be definitely dealing with a Cancer sign because Cancer card is in your surrounding and it is the only major arcana in the entire layout here. What's crossing you is that you are not getting some clarity or truth or some information that you want, and Ace of Swords as a challenge is also absolute no communication in a way. Like either there is communication which is a miscommunication or a breakdown in communication is basically Ace of Swords as a challenge is what I'm getting here. I'm also getting that in future you are planning to defend yourself or someone around you is trying to defend themselves. Right now I feel that you're also feeling that you are left out in the cold, and like somebody around you has moved on and you have been left out in the cold. That's what I'm getting here. And then I'm getting that in past somebody was ignoring either you, basically you were being ignored, or you were ignoring somebody else in a way that you wanted to speak about your facts and not emotions. So somebody decided that they don't want to be emotional and they will just talk about facts. That's all. What's on your mind is that either some of you are facing rejection or you are rejecting somebody. Also, as an outcome here, I'm getting Daughter of Cups, which is either you will be receiving an offer by the end of the November, month of November, or your fear is that, your hope is that somebody that you truly, truly want will come and offer you a cup of love, or your, did I say fear or hope? I don't know. Your hope is that you will find someone, like a connection that you are sharing with somebody, that person will come back and offer you a cup of love or an apology. But for some of you, the fear is that that somebody returns and you don't want them to return, and you're feeling defensive, like you don't want this person in your life because they make you feel very alone. And what I'm getting here is that there is something related to that you had invested in and you were waiting for something to come back, like returns, and that's not happening. Like probably that is the issue here. And Father of Cups is the heart of the matter. I'm getting that maybe you were in love with somebody who is a water sign, or you are now basically feeling that you are finally able to control your emotions. And you are very much like a stoic person, like stoic you are letting life happen without being emotionally reactive to it. So you feel very balanced. And in past, if I see this as you, mother of sorts, then you have been very cutting in a way that you don't want bullshit. And someone has been eluding you in a sense that they are not sharing some information, or they are not being truthful. So probably you sense that. And Daughter of Wands here, as the overall energy, I'm getting that there is someone very bold, someone who is very charismatic as well. And this person is basically this is someone who comes into your life and then leaves. Like there can be some passion. I'm getting passion. But this person comes and goes, and there is nothing very concrete, which is something concrete is not developing, because there is no pentacle in this reading. I'm getting that you guys, if you are dealing with someone, don't have anything material that you have shared or that you have built together. So there is nothing long lasting here that I am seeing. Something there is nothing long lasting here. There is only waiting. There is rejection. There is feeling left out in the cold. There is feeling defensive. All those cards are here, but there is nothing which shows me that there is an opportunity to develop something in a solid way. Like for a relationship, all the elements that you need, those elements are missing. I also feel that you find yourself defending yourself against this person who has probably betrayed you in the past. And to be very honest, this person is unaffected. Whoever this person is that you're dealing with, this person is unaffected. I don't think they even realize what kind of mess that they have created. But at the same time, I see that you have started putting out putting boundaries. That's something I'm getting here. And you have started to defend your light, your wisdom also. I'm getting you have started to defend your light and wisdom. So that's what I'm getting here. And then I'm getting that some of you probably are going through a divorce situation. If I'm not wrong, there can be some love situation with a earth sign like a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Mostly a Taurus person basically. And I'm feeling that you feel very worthy and you feel very much in control now. Because I feel that you have gone through some sort of a emotional up and down, and you have discovered self-love or healing. And you had to go through this because something like Justice card is telling me some karma had to be balanced. And because we already have a karmic card here, so that's why you are fearing this person, because you don't want this energy back in your life. And Daughter of Wands is telling me that you are ready to be bold and outgoing and date other people, but at the same time putting your boundaries in place. This can be you as well as an outcome who is trying to approach other people and start being friendly, because right now I feel that you are not feeling satisfied. You are feeling very, very bored with the things that you already have, and you have been waiting for something to come back as well. Now I don't know what that thing is that you are waiting for to come back, but I see here that you can have support from your friends and family, and you yourself, the three element, can start to create something new. Now since you are still feeling very much left out in the cold, the only thing that I'm feeling here is that give yourself some time and care. That's one thing that I'm getting. Let me pull out few more cards. What is the blockage for Sagittarius for November 2018? Blockage for Sagittarius. If you want to correct something with this person, I am feeling that you need to start communicating. I feel that some of you are not communicating with anyone at all. Now the blockage card that has come out for you is isolation. So what is isolation? By the way, in this card you can see that there is this thing is basically an invitation. This person is carrying an invitation, and this is the suit that is ready for you to. Okay, so bottom of the deck, by the way, is the self-worth. So that is what that's the vibe that I'm getting, actually, that earlier you did not recognize your worth, and now you do recognize your worth because of the experience that you have gone through. And right now you are in a very defensive mode and feeling very left out as well. But it's telling me that it's time for you to go out and see new people, and don't wait for other people to come and join you. You will have to take that first step, is what I'm getting here. Even if you are not going to take that first step, you need to be open to other people inviting you, and then you being a part of that group, just in a fun way, nothing serious. And I'm getting that if you have built some wall around you, try to have a window in that wall so that you can talk to some people who are beneficial to you. So if you're trying to block out everybody from your life, then you will be left alone, which is not a good place to be. So have a window in that wall. I'm saying not to pull the entire wall down, because boundaries are important, and I think you are still learning how to place boundaries. So good luck with that, and make sure that inside the wall you are still taking care of yourself, and giving yourself all the nourishment and all the love that you usually should be getting from people outside. But talk to yourself in a way that you show yourself a lot of love, and because self-worth is coming up, and I'm also getting rejection. So some of you might have gone through some sort of a rejection because it's on your mind. Somebody might have rejected you, so you might not be feeling great about it, and that's okay. You tried your best, and it's okay if somebody rejected you. It's good. You can obviously look for somebody else. I'll tell you one thing. Once you move on from the person or the object of your desire to another thing, the moment you break that energy, the person probably who rejected you will miss that energy. They'll start to miss that energy, and then they will be the one approaching you, because they are used to that energy. And once you will detach from them, they will realize what's missing from their life. So until unless you do that and distract yourself to something else and start building your own life and working on your own self, the person that you're trying to impress is not going to get impressed. So the irony here is that if you really want to impress somebody or want somebody back in your life, first you will have to totally detach from that person in order to get them back. So that was the reading for you, Sagittarius. I'll pull out one more card, which is from the Sacred Rebel deck, and let's see what's the message for you in there. I'm also getting that some of you are trying to balance your mind, body, soul, and you're trying to align yourself so that you can move forward in your journey without any obstruction, without any breakdown, basically. So you are trying to give yourself that maintenance, basically. You are trying to maintain yourself in a way that you can move forward without looking back. And then here the card that's coming out for you is Spirals of Manifestation. So Spirals of Manifestation is basically you're trying to manifest something. Like I said, and by the way, you also have inner trust. So when it comes to self-worth, obviously you need to have inner trust. You need to start by trusting yourself, and then confiding in at least one person whom you can trust. So yeah, Spirals of Manifestation, like I was telling you, with Pentacles. The Pentacles energy is right now missing in your life. Basically, I think you are not making enough money if I can say that, or financially you're not probably doing so well. So if you're looking for job and stuff like that, there is something coming up, like you need to delve into your creativity, because I have two Father of Cups and Daughter of Cups and Four of Cups here and Six of Cups there. So a lot of whatever you build, be emotionally invested in that, and try to give it try to look at it from a practical point of view as well. And soon you will understand what you are, you know, what you are trying to. Actually, my voice is breaking. I don't even have water here. Yeah, soon you will start moving in a direction where, you know, you will be able to, whatever that you have built, you will be able to show it to the world and ask for its worth, basically. So focus on what you are making, and rejection is basically a blessing in disguise. So keep that in mind. I'll see you again. Bye-bye.